All right. Let's dive in to some ASAX.html code. You will need an XML HTTP request object that you have to initialize it to false. Of course, if your browser has a can give an XML HTTP request, your XML HTTP request object will be created. Else, if you have the ActiveX object, the Windows Explorer, the new XML HTTP request object will be new ActiveX object, Microsoft XML HTTP. Okay. Now inside the form, our form, we have two buttons. On click and on click event, we call the get data function, and we send as a first parameter the PHP file inside the quotes. The second parameter, you see here, the get data function accepts three parameters. First is the data source, is the PHP file that we will post the data, we'll send an XML request with open. Okay, post data source. Data source is the name of the file, it's data responder PHP. Is this file here? This file here. Okay. The second parameter is the div ID. Is the ID of this div here. That says the fetch message will appear here. Okay. This is the ID of the div or div. And what else? Yes. This is very important. The send request header on the type application slash x dash www dash form w dash URL encoded. This is very important to send for the send the request. And on ready state change, that means that we have sent the XML HTTP request object into the function. If the ready state is equal to 4, that means that we have succeeded the connection, and the status is 200, that means that there is no error inside our page. Object, the div here, okay, the div equals to response text from the request object. Remember, the request object has opened a stream here to communicate with the PHP file, with this data source here. Okay. And after that, we send back to the browser the data, this data here. Okay. This data here. We send the data to the PHP file. Okay. Okay. If here we write something else, let's say message. Let's see what happens. here if post data equals to 1, we print a message. If post data equals to 2, we print another message. Let's see what happens. We have to change this. Είχε πάνω σχολίγας, me says that you send the server a value of 1. And this, you send a value of 2. This is the Ajax example. So when we press the first button inside the HTML form, we send a value of 1. Okay. So that's why the PHP script code knows that to have sent the value of 1. So it prints this message. Else. We print another message, value of 2. So this is the Ajax example. This is how to communicate with the PHP file. And this is how to open the connection. Okay. Thank you very much, goodbye.